and welcome. My name is David. I work for the Port Adelaide Enfield Libraries. I work as a STEM specialist and library officer. And today, I wanted to talk to you about pressure, pushes and pulls. But I want to do it in a kind of a special way. I want to show you this. Now, this is one of my most favorite things in the world. This is called a Airzooka, or Toroidal Vortex Generator. Yeah, I know it looks like a bucket, but it's actually very fun. Now, it's really just a container with a hole at the front and what amounts to a piece of plastic at the back and a little bit of elastic. Now, I'm gonna pull this back. I'm gonna fire it at the camera and... Did you see it? What do you mean you didn't see it? I'll do it again, hang on. How about that? Did you see it? No, okay, fair enough. Sometimes in science, we have things happening in the universe that our senses can't pick up. But that's when we've developed tools or ways of measuring it in different ways. And one of the things I can use to show you this very special thing is one of these. This thing, have you seen this? This is a smoke machine or fog generator. If I fire it, there you go, you can see, oh, sorry. There you go, now you can see me again. So, we're gonna use that to show you the toroidal vortex. Now I'm gonna put it in here and I'm gonna just squirt a little bit of this fog. Woo. Now all this does is heat up water vapor. Okay, and give you this dry, sort of vapored fog with a bit of oil. So if I'm very careful, you can see it coming out, and I'm going to just gently, because if I do it too fast, you'll miss it, I'm going to gently pull back and let go and see if you can spot my toroidal vortex. Whoa! Did you see it? Or was that too fast? Whoa, there's another one. Oh, that one's getting better. Oh! Do you notice the shape of them? They're doughnuts. And that's in the name, toroidal, okay, which is a doughnut-shaped object in physics. So toroidal vortice, and vortice means something that's wrapped around itself. So really this is a doughnut-shaped wave traveling in the air, and it's got direction. Like you'll notice that it went towards you. If I do it again, just a little bit. We can aim it. I can aim it that way, I can aim it up, I can aim it down, I can aim it wherever I want, and it will travel in the direction that I point it. And that's because we're giving it a push. That's what that's doing. It's giving it a great big thwack. The air inside gets shoved really hard, and it comes out through the hole. Now, fast-traveling air actually creates a low pressure because there's less bits in that given space, in that area, because it's moving so fast, there's less bits. And what that means is, as a low pressure, it drags air in around it that's at a higher pressure. I mean, air, just like most things, sits around and does nothing unless it's pushed or pulled. And so as that air moves, it drags the other air in and it starts to wrap it up around itself. So the air that slows down on the inside, the air that gets dragged into the flow as it's moving out, all create this wrapped up energy, this wrapped up wave that travels towards you. Now, the thing is, I've got a couple of books. It's actually one of the reasons that we can fly. Actually, this ability to cause air to move or flow or wrap up around itself is a key foundation to the physics of flight. It's actually what took us so long to move from that to that, because nature had done it over slow incremental time. We were trying to do it really quickly, and it took us a long time to work it out. All right, the shape of the wing and how things work. But that might be a story for another day. I thought we would actually make one of these. Well, not this big, because if you go and make a hole in a bucket, your mum and dad gets a bit upset. So, instead, what you need is this. So I'm gonna grab my overhead camera And we're going to try and do some stuff so that you can actually see it overhead. Okay, so we've transitioned to my camera overhead. All right, so what we've got here, right, is a cup. I know it doesn't look very exciting, but it is a paper cup. I prefer paper cups if possible, because you can break them down later and decompose them a lot easier than plastic cups. So we've got a pair of scissors, okay, as well. Oops, make sure they're in frame. Pair of scissors, a cup, and we've got a piece of aluminium foil as well. So a piece of aluminium foil and rubber band and also a pencil, all right? The pencil's for poking things as well to get it started. It's a really simple build. Again, what you've got is the cup for the chamber, all right? That's where most of the air is inside when you're giving it a tap. You've got to create a hole, but you need to come from the inside and push out if possible. So I'm gonna poke in so you can see and make a hole. Now that hole, unfortunately, isn't quite big enough. If you have that, all that bits, can you see all those bits? If you have them on the inside, right, it won't make the doughnut very well, or it won't make the vortice very well. So you've got to have them on the outside. So you want to take that and a pair of scissors. Now remember, when you've got a pair of scissors, hopefully they're child safe scissors, or get an adult to do it instead for you, all right? If you can find a thicker pencil, that might do as well. So if you've got a nice big chunky pencil, you might not need to use the scissors, but we want to make the hole a bit bigger. All right, I want to try and make it a bit bigger so that what we've got is something about the size of your little finger that will fit through, okay? Roughly, okay? So that there gives you a nice hole. It's meant to be about a third the size of the other end, thereabouts. You can play with that size. You can do a series of them and give them a try, but again, that's the experimenting part. Feel free to try building those with different size holes and see if they're as effective. Now, I know not all of you are going to have smoke machines at home. That's fine. But what you can do, all right, is use lavender oil or eucalyptus oil inside, and that will make a smell. What we want to do is add our piece of aluminium foil over the top and just take our rubber band and wrap it round. And that is the build for our miniature vortex cannon. All right, so if you've got a little bit of smoke, we might, or I in this case have got a little bit of smoke, I can hopefully show you those vortexes again. So let's see if I can get a little bit of smoke. Okay, let's see if you can see this coming up. If I give it a gentle tap. Can you see the little vortices coming out? So, again, with this, all you're doing is creating a little push to get air moving fast so that it generates a push and a flow to create those doughnut shaped waves. Well, I hope you've enjoyed that idea or that experiment. You can give it a go while you're not with us at the moment. Try that, see if you bother your little brother or sister or your mums or dads, all right? But that is the physics of vortices. Until next time, stay safe, keep curious, and see you in the libraries. Bye.